I've already been trying to start this video for like 4 or 5 minutes now, and I just feel like I have no energy. I'm not as loud and excited as some of the other DIY YouTubers out there. You know what, let me try to watch some stuff. Maybe I'll learn something or like get some tips.
What is up, my beautiful Mars, and welcome back to my YouTube today!
Actually, I don't think I have those type of drugs. Oh no, I kinda regret that one actually. Don't slew me, it's just a joke, I promise. But what is going on, my peeps? Welcome back to this week's brand new video. Now, as most of you know, this past Sunday was Easter. Last week, I tried to get a little bit festive and wear my Easter flannel, but I made edible cookie dough. That's not very Easter-esque. So this week, I decided to do some Easter leftover hacks and do a video that I saw a long, long time ago on Buzzfeed Videos channel, the original channel they used to post all their recipes on, and it is the Smores pizza. Now, I have done something similar to this in the past. It was the pumpkin spice latte pizza, which was one of the most vomit-inducing recipes we have done on the history of this show, so hopefully this will come out a little bit better. Thank you to anyone who has suggested this in the past couple years since it's been out. Sorry I'm a little late on this, but let's get right into it. Not gonna lie, this recipe is pretty simple and straightforward, guys. The really only labor-intensive part is making the graham cracker crust. And for that, you wanna start with a half cup of softened butter, which is one stick. Use your electric mixer to make that nice and fluffy. Add to that 1 cup of white sugar and again mix. Mixing for about 45 to 60 seconds in between each one of these. Then add 1 egg, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. Mix one last time and we can set that aside to start working on the dry ingredients. In a brand new bowl, you want to start with 1.5 cups of crushed up graham crackers, 1.5 cups of flour, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, and 1 teaspoon of cream of tartar. I do not know what in the world this is, but I put it in. I quickly used my whisk to mix all of the dry ingredients thoroughly throughout the bowl. Once that is done, I threw in the ball of wet ingredients, which is kind of like just a ball of butter sugar at this point. And you want to combine the two until you get a nice crumbly graham cracker dough. Now you want this mixture to kind of be like that kinetic sand, if you know what I'm talking about. This was on the crumbly side, just a tad, so I added about 1 teaspoon of water, mixed that in, and then after that, it came out pretty much perfect. To finish up with the crust, I just grabbed the biggest cookie sheet that I could find. I put a layer of my cooking spray down first, and then the ball of dough. Now, I don't think the shape of this really matters. You can make a square, a rectangle, whatever size pan you have. Mine was big enough to make a circle, though. Now, once you finish that up and set it aside, this is where your Easter leftovers can come into play. I'm gonna use these chocolate bunnies made out of milk chocolate and break them up and melt them down in the microwave. Now, I don't remember exactly how many ounces these bars of chocolate were, but I kinda just eyeballed it anyway. And once I got it completely melted down, I threw a nice thick layer over my crust and set the remainder of the chocolate off to the side to use in just a couple minutes. Now, remember how I said that this was gonna be a holiday leftover hack video? I figured, why just Easter? I found these 4-month-old peppermint marshmallows in my basement that I guess my mom's been hoarding since December. So I'm gonna use those as well. Do marshmallows have an expiration date? I feel like they might, but at this point, they're already on the pizza, so it's too late to turn back now. But once you got all your marshmallows spread across your pizza, all you have to do is drizzle some of the leftover chocolate across the top in a nice little pattern, and then finish the entire thing off with some crushed up graham crackers that you sprinkled over the top of the entire thing. That goes off into a 350 degree oven for 10 to 15 minutes. I kept mine in for about 13 minutes, and this thing is looking banging. A little bit odd with the pink marshmallows on the top. It kinda wouldn't really resemble something super edible, but we know it is, so let's give it a try. Now, it has been about 20 or 30 minutes since I took it out of the oven. So it's nice and cooled, and to my surprise, the graham cracker like hardened like a real graham cracker when it browned in the oven. So you can actually kind of hold this thing like a real piece of pizza. This thing smells absolutely fantastic, so I can't imagine it tasting even remotely bad. Mmm. Guys, this thing is so damn good. Oh my god, I would definitely be on the floor by now if falling was still something that I did. The chocolate is like gooey and delicious. The marshmallows fit in perfectly. Just smacked my knee. Okay, but on a very real note, this thing is absolutely incredible. I highly recommend that you try that. I don't know if the peppermint is making a huge difference. I don't really taste it that much. But the number one thing that makes this is that graham cracker crust. That is next level. It almost has the same texture and mouthfeel as like a brownie, almost, but it tastes exactly like one of the best like warm graham cracker flavors. Besides the copious amounts of sugar obviously in this thing and how unhealthy it is for you, I really don't have any other complaints, so this thing has to get a 10 out of 10. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's BuzzFeed test. If you did, smash a like on this video for me. I would love it if we could hit 6,542. Don't know why that number exactly, but let's see if we can do it. Make sure to hit up both my Twitter and Instagram if you have not yet. I'm trying to get back on the grind, posting consistently on both one of those. I've been slacking a little bit recently. And huge, huge announcement for those of you who stayed all the way to the end. If you guys live in Orlando or you're going to Playlist Live, I will be there also. I haven't really announced it much on YouTube yet. So if you're going, let me know. We gotta hang out. The whole entire weekend, I'll be tweeting out where I'm at. So make sure to keep an eye out for that. But other than that, I hope you have an absolutely awesome rest of your week. And I'll see you right back here for the next video. Peace.